We are
Done.
live. We are live.
Good afternoon, sir. Principal sir, good afternoon. Very welcome. Warm welcome to you, to Vasishth sir, to Ahuti ma'am, Media Club, and to all the students who are awaiting for this phase two eagerly on our YouTube channel, GCBVN Students. This is Himanshu Srivastava, and we have once again come up with an online lecture series, phase two. This time coming up with more of soft skills topic, and today is the very first lecture by Dr. Vasishth. He is going to speak on presentation strategies, a call to action. A very innovative tag has been given to presentation strategies, which defines a lot. Without wasting much of the time, I would just request Principal Sir to share his kind views, because it is ultimately he who has motivated me to coordinate and to organize these events. Sir, please.
Thank you, Dr. Srivastava, for coming with the next series of lectures for the communication subject, and all the students of GECs and almost all students of GTU affiliated colleges will be benefited. So I would like to congratulate Dr. Srivastava for coming up and coordinating with all the faculty members of all the GECs. And we are thankful to all the professors of all GEC professors who have been a part of this series. Earlier we had 11 lectures, and that was a successful series. It was appreciated by Honorable Vice Chancellor and the other authority, higher authorities. They appreciated the way we are doing it without any kind of hurdles. I think all faculties were ready to be the part of this series. Let's hope today Dr. Vasishth J. Patel, who is a faculty from GEC Gandhinagar, will be a motivating factor for the students of all the institutions affiliated to GTU, and it will add to the value of communication skill. As already we are saying that we are in trouble since last couple of years, because the background of the students is a Gujarati medium, and finally, even though they are having a very good technical knowledge, somehow during their presentation or they are facing the interview, they face interview, probably they are good at technicality, but when they speak, I think the impression which is created is not that up to the mark of a corporate world. So probably this kind of efforts by all of you, all faculty of communication, will help our engineers to be a smart engineer. And I hope this will add to the value of all the students who are logged in today. And probably this is on YouTube channel, so anytime anybody can have a look at it, and finally they can learn from what the teachers have been talking about the various topics. Today is a call to action. I think it's new for me also, but as Dr. Srivastava said, it's about presentation strategies, so I can understand how to present and whatever maybe. I don't know exactly what is the meaning of call to action, but I'm sure the way how the people are presenting, way the students are going to present in future for their interviews or other things, I'm sure this will, I think they will get some kind of hit or some kind of tricks or some kind of way of presenting the things, and that will help the students to learn from today's lecture from Dr. Vasishth Patel. So I'm thankful to Vasishth Patel for sparing his valuable time. And today we have said that yesterday we had a talk with Dr. Srivastava. So like we have made it very clear that it is for all affiliated institution of GTU. It is not only for GEC Bhavnagar, for all the students of affiliated colleges of GTU. So I think we have broadened the outlook, and finally we want that everybody should be benefited. So with this word, I would like to thank once again Dr. Vasishth and Dr. Srivastava again for always coming in action, right, without taking a risk, because every week we are doing something new in the institution, and he is the only, he's always one of the key elements for the institution development. So thank you, Dr. Srivastava, Ahuti madam, who is always available for such activities, and all the faculty members, students who are, and our media club president specifically. Our students are the most, I would say, they are always, when we say we want to do this, they are always ready. And Media Club is one of the important integral club of all our 14 clubs of GEC Bhavnagar. Because any club is there, Media Club plays a very important role. So they are doing wonderful every time. As per the, I think, words of Dr. Srivastava, members of Media Club will be always present. So all red goes to Dr. Srivastava and the members of the media club. Thank you very much, Dr. Srivastava. And thank you once again, Dr. Vashishth, for coming forward to enrich the students of accredited colleges of GTU. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir. It's definitely said about a communication skills expert that, you know, he or she always comes with something, a topping on the Monica biscuit. That's how you a communication skill teacher is defined. And so that caption is added, a call to action, which will be truly defined by Vasistha. Ma'am, your kind words. Ma'am is just like, you know, a support system to me. I mean, like we just have had a talk that we would like to come up with the event and all, and she said just to me that if we can arrange this quite earlier than what we did last time, so it would be more beneficial. So here I am with once again phase two. Ma'am, your kind words.
Yes. Very good evening and warm welcome to you, Dr. Vasishtha sir. And as dear students, as you know well that during this COVID and even in post-COVID time, presentation will not be something that will be occasional, but it will be woven both in your academic as well as in your professional life also. Because this online that is now part and parcel of our daily routine will not disappear so soon. So every time, every now and then, we will have to keep ourselves so ready to present ourselves both on online mode and whenever necessary offline mode. There is also one point to be considered. Generally, we believe that whenever the word presentation comes and it comes in our mind that it is a PowerPoint presentation or any presentation that is with the help of online tools. But, and it is true also that now onwards in post-COVID time, mostly presentation will be of this kind. But whenever we learn the strategies of presentation, they do apply to offline presentation, speaking before the audience in the physical mode also, and on various other platforms also. So never interpret presentation in that narrow sense that presenting with the online tools only. And there is also humble request to our resource person that if we relate this session with the syllabus of our third semester students, then this is only the second week and all of our students are not well introduced to the concept of communication still. And that is why whenever there is any scope, meanwhile in your presentation, please go on drawing the attention of our students towards the basic principles of communication skills. Thank you, sir, and have a nice session ahead. Hello.
Was this sir ready?
Yes, sir.
There are many students from different semesters also, because it's a topic which is not pertaining to a particular semester. We have actually designed a very nice syllabus. It is pertaining to a larger mass. And in fact, you know, when I teach this topic, I always say that there are certain topics that English and PPC has that are and that will be with you till you are on this earth. Because these are certain things that is directly or indirectly, you are definitely a part of it and they are a part of you. So, sir, it's all your call. Students are live. If they have any query, I request all the students to raise your queries. I'll be asking on your behalf at the end of the session. Okay. So, please, you know, mention your queries in the comment box, students. And, sir, please.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Just to interrupt, I forwarded this flyer to Honorable Vice Chancellor and the other authority of the university. And they have sent the best wishes to Dr. Srivastava and all the people who are associated with this club, this program. So just to say that it all best wishes for Honorable Vice Chancellor, Register of the University. So they appreciated this venture of having a various web series, online series for communication skills improvement. So I think this is very, very important, because this is what is lagging and this is what is to be improved. So, again, congratulations, Dr. Srivastava. And one more thing, from this year, Dr. Srivastava in Board of Studies of Humanities also. So I think this will help all faculty of communication skill to pass on whatever you want to convey, so that it can be implemented as a whole in university. So I think he is the person on behalf of all communication skill teachers. I think one more person is also there, but he is also one of the member of Board of Study of Humanities. So objective.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Vasish, sir, it's your role.
Yes. Yes, thank you, GP Vadodariya, sir. Thank you, Himanshu, sir, and Nahuti, ma'am, for inviting me. Today's topic, presentation strategies, a call to action. So, basically, as you all know, that the presentation is to explain in a systematic way, which should have a formal touch. So, for every kind of presentation, giving presentation has been a crucial one. So there would be a difficult situation in which you need to give presentation in different manners, and at the same time, you should be effective. So presentation normally is not only limited to deliver our idea or thoughts, but when you are to write something in a very systematic manner, there should be a sound presentation skill is required. In both the types of communication, whether it is oral one or written one, some special set of skills is required. While presenting in writing, certain technicalities are to be followed. And to be an effective oral presenter, one requires practicing more and more. Three P's are there: plan, prepare, and practice. So practicing more and more. So an effective presentation is the one that makes the best use of the relationship between the presenter and audience. So as a presenter and audience, now we are together now. So presentation strategies, a call to action. Why I added a call to action, even Vadodariya sir has rightly mentioned, there should be something meaningful of the title, presentation strategies, a call to action. So whenever you go for giving a presentation, you need to put yourself into certain actions. And those actions will be from your side. From your side and from audience side. The presentation, first step that you go for giving a presentation, that you are thinking that these are the things that are to be taken care of, and these are the things to be understood very well before going for the presentation. So whenever you go for giving a presentation, certain outlined points to be prepared well. You need to understand first the purpose of the presentation. I'm sharing my screen with you so that you can have certain look at some of the points. Outlined points. The very first thing that you need to understand, the purpose. What is the purpose of giving such presentation? Your purpose, you need to define the purpose. First, that you need to define the purpose. Whenever you define the purpose, generally your presentation is arranged for an explanation of particular issue. For which issue that you are going to give a presentation, that you need to clear in your mind. Yes, for this purpose, my purpose is to give the presentation is giving information, persuasion, and any other purpose that you need to define first. While presentation may be for collaboration, for problem solving, or for making a major decision, it depends on the situations where the presentation is required, where the presentation is arranged. In short, Presentation includes the information, analysis, explanation, and persuasion. Your presentation purpose can be informative, giving an information, analytical analysis should be there, explanation will be there, and persuasion will be there. These are the most of the parts where you need to give the presentation. So once you are clear in your ideas, once you are very much clear in your purpose, okay, then before going for giving the presentation, this picture also tells you that you need to first design your presentation as per the need of the audience. Okay, as per the need of the audience. Different shapes are given over there, different images are given over here. That decides that your audience will definitely be a different kinds, in different gender, in different age, in different having different qualifications. There may be a variable things available in your audience. It can be gender wise, it can be a under 18, it can be a graduate student, it can be a different. So whenever you go for giving a presentation, that you first need to understand your audience. Okay, understanding the audience and the place where you are going to present your views. Once you understand your audience, it will very easy for you to have a look at the content, the words, the vocabulary that you are choosing in a very systematic way. Because sometimes once you understand your audience, to know their level, knowledge, background, culture, expectation, etc. There are certain things to be taken care of. Okay, there are many things to be taken care of. So in that, you need to understand their level, knowledge, background, culture, and expectations. Your presentation should be audience oriented. Very well. Fix this in your mind. Whenever you go for giving a presentation, don't think that I know this, that's why I'm giving my views. You need to first understand what are the requirements of the audience. What are the things the audience is needed? You need to change your presentation as per the need of the audience. You need to change your presentation as per the need of the time as well. Okay. So, if I'll give you an example. If you are going for giving a presentation in women empowerment program, and there should not be a talk of men dominated society. This is normally understood issue, that women empowerment program is there, so there has to be a talk of women empowerment. So this comes from your purpose, for which purpose that you go, and then you understand your audience. So as an effective speaker, you make a certain efforts to understand audience and the place as well. Okay. Now you are clear about your audience. Now you are very much clear about your place where you are going to give the presentation. Even I would suggest that sometimes you need to visit that place where you are going to give the presentation, if possible. So that you can have certain setups in your mind. You can have certain things in your mind that if you are having any doubt regarding the place, that can be cleared out. Now, once you have understood your audience, it's time to take up certain content from the different sources. Okay. From the different sources that you need to take your content. Different sources in terms of nowadays, the people are taking some content from online. You can visit certain libraries. Even online libraries are available. So that you need to collect the content. And the content that you are collecting based on your topic, once you have decided your topic, based on the content, you need to filter that content. because all the content that you are not going to use. So that content that you need to take care of. And it becomes very important for the speaker to organize the content logically. Whatever the content that you have taken, it will be in a scattered manner that you need to organize by. So as a speaker, it comes with a different kind of information regarding the topic or presentation. So it will create the battery effect on the audience. Okay. So once you need to organize that content in the particular manner, for example, introduction should be there. Main body of the content will be there and the conclusion. And in between, if you are using certain aids, visual aids, it could be a good thing. Okay. Now, when you are going to organize your content, the first thing that we have discussed is introduction. So this section of the presentation talks about the relevance of the topic, definition of the topic, or how it starts. With any suitable quote, anecdote, or brief story of the topic, which leads the audience to understand the importance of the topic. So in introduction, that you need to give the basic things about your topic, brief about your topic. Okay. That's why the audience would be well prepared for understanding the rest of the content. Now, when it comes to the main body of the content, it should be a central idea. Okay. It could be a chronological, categorical, cause and effect, problem solution, contrast and comparison. It should be there. It should be in a chronological order, categorical order, cause and effect that you need to show. Then you need to show the problem and solution and contrast and comparison. That you need to make them understand in a very main body of the content, because main body of the content is very well defined, that whatever you have shared your views about the presentation, about your topic. So main body will lead the audience to the total understanding of it. Now, the third one, that is the conclusion. Conclusion is one of the most important part. Because when you conclude, the audience would be recapturing or recalling their ideas, their thoughts, that whatever thoughts that you have shared, they will be recalling their memories. So this section contains brief summary of the points which are discussed in the body. Appropriate words should be used to conclude the topic. Whenever you go for concluding the topic, okay, that it should be in a way that the people would be able to understand the clear-cut idea about the topic. Now I'm sharing one video with you. Just have to look at and we'll discuss something about this. I'm sharing my video with you. Yes, so this video is all about how the people are using PowerPoint, how they are making certain mistakes whenever they are going to be making the PowerPoint presentation. This video is all about showing the bifurcation between good and bad in the presentation. I'm sharing my video with you. Yes.
There's some things I hate about PowerPoint, and I figure it's kind of my duty to point them out. So here we go. Here's common PowerPoint mistakes. Number one, people tend to put every word they are going to say on their PowerPoint slides. Although this eliminates the need to memorize your talk, ultimately this makes your slides crowded, wordy, and boring. you will lose your audience's attention before you even reach the bottom of your first slide. Please don't do that anymore, please. Number two, most common, many people do not run spell check. Big mistake. Nothing makes you look stupider than spelling errors. If it's got a red line under it, recheck the spelling. And then finally, I hate this. Avoid excessive bullet pointing, only bullet key points. Too many bullet points, and your key messages will not stand out. In fact, the term bullet point comes from people firing guns at annoying presenters. Hence the bullet point. Bad color schemes, not good. Clashing background and font colors can lead to distraction, confusion, headache, nausea, vomiting, and loss of bladder control. I can't stay on that one too long. Here's something I've noticed. The number of PowerPoint slides you have in your talk, the less useful your talk actually is. Unfortunately, my presentation is right there. I've also noticed this. People love to pack data into their presentations. They shove more and more data thinking it's better, but it's not. The more data you have, the harder it is to read your slide, and the effectiveness plummets. Now, you can improve the effectiveness by adding some shading and some 3D effects and then some second order and third order effects. And then, I know, let's add some labels. That'll help a lot. And that's pretty much every marketing slide I've ever seen right there. Yeah. Then some like VP of marketing standing there going, it's real clear in Q4. What the hell are you talking about? Now, I'm into in animation. People become animators in PowerPoint. You can have things flying all over the place, and that can be good. If you're a visual learner, that will improve the effectiveness of your performance. But if you're easily distracted, more animations and people have no idea what you're talking about. They're just, wow, that is cool, wow. And there's regions here, by the way. There's the simple but effective region. There's the active but confusing, the effective but boring, the active but ineffective, the dull but static region, the busy but useless, the ADD only region, the useful but amusing, the stupid but confusing, the dull triangle, the hyper triangle, the sleepy square, the dizzying pentagon, and everything else I just call pointless motion. That slide right there took me an hour and a half to make right there. PowerPoint can just suck the life out of you. It's amazing. I've also come up with this. It's a kind of a little science I've invented called font analysis. Basically, the font you choose says something about who you are as a person. There's a huge list of fonts, and you choose one, and that says something about you. So be careful the font you choose. For example, if you choose Courier New, which happens to be my favorite, you're probably organized and structured. If you choose Matisse, it means you're artistic. And if you choose Times New Roman, it means you're lazy, apathetic, and unimaginative, and you always use the default. Oh.
Yes, a very well said, isn't it? So some of the spelling
the most amazing, yes, certainly, last year I showed this to the studios. Yes,
sir. So,
this is one of the, you know, and the best thing that you have come up for my students. Please continue, sir.
Yes. So, you must have observed some of the things that some of the spelling errors that normally people are making. So, whenever you are making a spelling errors, you need to double check your content. Whenever you go for reading, and this is the now problematic things that the people are not reading carefully. So whenever you go for double checking your presentation, your content, your responsibility is that you need to take care of the spelling errors first, because it is very common mistake that people are making. Okay. Sometimes you are using some in presentation, some bad colors and schemes as in shown in the video. Okay, sometimes bulleted fonts are too much bulleted fonts are given over there. sometimes it creating an effectiveness disorder. It creates an effect in a very negative manner. Okay, and one more thing, font analysis was given over that. Okay, so whenever you go for giving a presentation, make sure that this kind of preparation that you will take care, this kind of mistakes that you are not going to make in the presentation. Okay, now using of visual aids. Now again, I'm sharing my screen so that you could have certain ideas. Yes, visual aids. So whenever you use the visual aids, so it may be used to as notes to emphasize and clarify the points of the topic. Okay, it includes the charts, pictures, PowerPoint presentation, etc. Because to make the audience understand, you are having certain abstract ideas whenever you are discussing something. Okay, you are having some abstract ideas that visual aids that become an important medium. Okay, so that these visual aids convert your abstract idea into the concrete ideas. Use of visual aids will make your presentation effective. Like sometimes you feel sleepy after completion at the end of the lecture. So if somebody is showing you some video, somebody is showing you a kind of clip, you are suddenly awakened and you are getting an interest. So this makes visual aids your audience to be awakened. Now, whenever you go for giving a presentation, that you need to understand about certain delivery methods, which method that you are going to use. There will be a four methods, okay, that you need to decide that, okay, fine, this method that I am going to use. The very first one is extemporaneous. It's very popular and it's spontaneous overflow of the subject. Extemporaneous method, if you are going to use, it does not require detailed preparation, but to look at the main points, okay, starting from in front of the audience, and it requires the best oratory skills. If you are choosing this extemporaneous method, if you are sure about your delivery of presentation, then wisely choose this method. Okay, extemporaneous. Second one is manuscript. It means the speech is written in a very paper and speaker has to read on. Manuscript method has a written speech over there on the podium, and the speaker is continuously speaking from the. You might have observed some of the politicians, those who are coming on the stage having the ready-made script and they are reading over. So this is manuscript method. And impromptu. Third one is impromptu. It is very informal style of presentation where non-business gatherings are over there and is very natural in tone and it gives no stress to speaker and listener understand it very easily. Whenever you are having certain informal type of communication, informal type of gatherings over there, this method can be used. And the most important method, that is the last one, that is memorization. This method of presentation is very difficult for most of us. So what is there in the method? In this method, entire speech is memorized. Entire speech is memorized. And this type of delivery stands between extemporaneous and manuscript presentation. Memorization method can be used if you are sure that I will be able to memorize entire content of mine. Then wisely choose. Our Honorable Prime Minister is using most of the time this method, memorization. He can memorize entire speech, okay, and he can deliver in a very humorous and very meaningful manner. Okay, now four methods. One is extemporaneous, manuscript, impromptu, and memorization. Out of these four methods, you can use any of the methods. Now, whenever you go for giving a presentation, The research is telling us that 20% of your presentation will be the verbal one, and 80% of the presentation will be of your non-verbal. Non-verbal elements are appearance, facial expression, eye contact, posture, gestures. These are playing a vital role in our presentation because it shows our interest, enthusiasm, dynamism, intention, and confidence to our audience. Okay. Whenever you are speaking, your expressions are the facial expressions, eye contact, postures. Okay. You need to use your body language effectively related to the content. Okay. So some of the tips are given over here. Wear a formal dress and use simple accessories. Use facial expressions to exhibit your enthusiasm and interest. Do not show irritation or anger even when someone interrupts you. Sometimes it may be not possible that someone is interrupting in between your presentation. That you need to give the answer in a very polite way. Use your facial expression in a very enthusiastic manner. And wear a formal dress. Then eye contact. Sometimes what happens whenever you go for giving a presentation? I'll talk about something about the stage fear in the later part of the presentation. Okay. Handling your stage fright. This is one of the most important tasks in the presentation. Because whenever you go for giving a presentation for the first time, you definitely have a stage fear, stage fright. How would I look? How would my presentation will be? How the audience will be look like to me? Okay. So you are avoiding sometimes the eye contact with the audience. Okay. Don't do that. Once you are making an eye contact with all the section of the audience, then you will be able to understand that your words are being caught by the audience or not. Okay. Well-timed gestures. Okay. Maintain certain distance with the audience. Whenever you are using a blackboard, okay, you need to raise your voice and look at the audience in between and try to concentrate on your ideas and your audience. So whenever you go for making certain non-verbal things in your presentation, it should be related to the content that you are using. It should be related to the words which you are using in your presentation. Okay, so whenever you make your verbal elements and non-verbal elements, it is very important for you that your non-verbal elements, making an eye contact, sometimes what happens, handling a stage fear, isn't it? It's very important part. You have planned well-planned, well-practiced, okay, well-prepared, and finally, this is the time for standing on the stage. You are standing on the stage for the first time. One rule, remember. Don't let the audience know that you are presenting for the first time. Audience doesn't know you are presenting for the first time. You showing them you are presenting for the first time. So don't do that. Make at least confident enough to be present, to be stand on the stage. This comes from the practice. Earlier we had talked about practice more and more. You can start practicing before your small group of friends, even in front of your family members. Start giving the presentation before the small audience, small people, small number of people. Then slowly and gradually increase the number of people in your audience. Once you have done this practice in a very well manner, it will be very easy for you to handle your stage fear in a very well. What happens at the time when you go on the stage? Once you go on the stage, how would the audience will recognize you? This question comes because before entering in the hall, before entering at the venue of your presentation, audience is already seated in that seat. Okay. Audience must be talking with each other. You enter on this in that particular venue, you stand on the stage. How do you prove that you are a presenter or you are a speaker? It will be understood by the audience by your appearance. The way that you have dressed, the way that you have combed your hair, the way that you have prepared well, it will come in your eyes with the confidence, so that the people will be able to easily understand that you are a speaker. Okay. Now, whenever you have clear in your mind that, yes, I am ready for the presentation, I am ready to give the presentation on the stage, you need to greet the audience. Once you well greet the audience and making an eye contact to the all sections of the audience. Sometimes what happens at the we all had such experience when we went for giving the presentation for the first time. Okay, trembling the legs, okay, hands. Sometimes that you need to make your eye contact on the whole sections of the audience, not at the particular corner. Do not ask the frequent questions to the same person. Okay. By this way that you can start your presentation very confidently and do not come directly to the point on the topic that you have chosen. You can have certain quotations, you can have certain question answering session for 5 minutes. Okay. Sometimes you can tell a story, a small story related to your topic. So this will make your audience prepared. Once you ask certain questions, very common questions, not related to the topic, but it will lead to the topic. Whenever you do that, the audience will automatically relate themselves to you. Yes. And do not put the audience into the confusion manner. Do not create any dilemma. Make it clear that you ask the question and very simply you get the answer. So this technique to make the relation between the audience and the speaker will help you throughout your presentation. So whenever you go for giving a presentation, up to some extent, you will have a certain fear. But do not let the audience know that you are having a fear. By using this techniques, okay, by using this way of giving a presentation, this will definitely make your presentation very effective, very informative, okay, a kind of some of the tips that you are going to give in the presentation that will lead the audience in a very system. As we have seen in the video very clearly, that if you are making a presentation in a very formal way, do not use the fancy letters, okay. So that will make your presentation very effective. Okay, sometimes avoiding the large fonts, sometimes decorative fonts are used, sometimes background is in a way that the people are getting difficulty to understand it. Multiple colors are you being used over there. Okay, you are sometimes using paragraphs and paragraphs in the presentation. Avoid this. Use certain points. And rest of the things to be elaborated by you. Very simple. And show only the required information. Okay, as we have started with this organizing content, whatever you have taken from the different sources, that you need to filter. Filtering is an art. Okay. So whenever you get the filter, whenever you use the filter, it will definitely use this particular understanding to the audience. Now we'll come to the vocabulary. As we have already discussed that you need to make the presentation as per the qualification, as per the gender, as per the level of the audience. Sometimes what happens, we are you're choosing certain vocabularies in a very jargons. Apne jargons na use karta hu ye. Normally we are using certain jargons. Okay. So what happens at the time, some unknown words that we are using. Okay, we need to understand first the level of the students. If you are talking with undergraduate students, your vocabulary should be based on their understanding. If you are talking with school children, obviously the vocabulary will be the level of their understanding. If you are talking with the masters of the students, the vocabulary can be the different one. Okay, the word dilemma. Okay, some of the students may not be understand. I'll give you the synonyms of the dilemma: dichotomy. Again, creating. Okay, not understanding by some of the students, but once I will use confusion, everybody will be able to understand. So your vocabulary, choosing the vocabulary, choosing the content as per the need of the audience, as per the level of the audience. Okay, so certain visual aids where that we have already talked about. Okay, certain visual aids. Okay, flip chart is there. Okay, some whiteboards, blackboards. Okay, some of the transparencies can be used, projectors. Okay, so whenever you are using certain visual aids, there will be some advantages and disadvantages that you need to keep yourself in a way that if you are stuck with any of the situation during the presentation, whenever you want it, sometimes it happens normally that the people are well planned, well prepared, and well practiced an electricity con. This kind of hazards will be there. So you should be very ready to give the presentation completely orally. Okay, without taking the help of your PowerPoint. So these are the things to be taken care of very well. Whenever you are using certain PowerPoint presentations, certain visual aids, that you need to take care that if all those things will not be available at the time of my presentation, I am very confident that I will be able to I will be able to give a presentation without certain help. So that confidence comes by your planned, prepared, and practiced. If you are well practiced, it will be very easy for you to understand the audience as well, to understand yourself. And finally, I would like to say that over planning kills magic. Don't do over planning. Plan is good, but once you do the over planning, it will kill the magic of your presentation. Okay, so do it in a very systematic manner. Do it in a very well structured manner so that you won't have any hazards while giving the presentation. You are well confident, well prepared, well practiced, so that once you are well confident, the people, audience will definitely understand that this speaker is very much effectively given his presentation. Okay, so at the end, I would like to tell you that whenever you plan for the presentation, don't plan with over-exaggeration. Okay, plan in a very systematic manner, well-organized manner, then your presentations will have certain effect, isn't it? Thank you. Thank you so much for your patience. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Definitely, it was a very fabulous Shishin, the way you have, you know, distributed the points, the way you have bifurcated them, was absolutely stunning. The, you know, distribution, when I was telling, I was telling the part of, like, you know, visual aids, you're taking care of visual aids, you're taking care of oral things, you're taking care of PPTs or transparencies. You mentioned even transparencies also. It was fabulous because these are the modes that one should be ready with, if at all, you know, and something that I liked the best about was that one should not overplan things, which was really, really very nice sentence that you added upon, that definitely things come, things go, things work according to your plan, but there are certain things that are random, that are with the go. It is like, you know, sometimes the audience direct you the way to move forward. So for that statement, a very nice a thumbs up that, you know, don't over plan, but just perform. Just perform. Be natural, be yourself. And thank you, sir. Seven mahine, Gujarat ke 7 mahine ke shuruaat humne Vasisht sir ke saath mein ki hai. Hopefully, we'll have a series of lectures.
Yes.
This is for all my students. Some of the students will be watching later on because one or two classes they have joined us, so they would be asking. If at all there are questions that my students are raising, probably most of them are thanking you only, sir. But if at all there is a question that comes later on, I'll be texting you up or sending you WhatsApp.
Yes, sir.
Because definitely, there are students who would be viewing this after 6 o'clock today.
Yes.
I have made such arrangement that today the set of questions should be answered. They should ask questions if they have, so that they are ready for tomorrow's session. Tomorrow, once again, my dear students, we are live 4 to 5 with one other topic. The topic and the poster will be shared to you. Ma'am, please share your valuable inputs.
Yes, yes. Thanks a lot, Dr. Vasisht Patel, sir. And I would like to say that your presentation itself was also one of the excellent illustrations of how to prepare and deliver presentation effectively. And you have covered and given justice almost to all the minute components of preparing as well as delivering presentation. And I'm sure that this session will be helpful to our students to become better presenters. Thank you, sir, for sparing your time.
Thank you, sir. I'll share my presentation with you as well. PPT.
So yes, sir. Yes, sir. Do share with me. And there are certain comments that my students want to read. They have appreciated you. Bahut acha laga padhne mein, sunne mein. Thank you.
Am I audible, Avuti ma'am?
Yes, sir, you are audible, sir. I think there is some error on a surf network.
Yes,
part.
Yes, yes.
See, Bhavnagar needs you. You'll always be there. I know that. With this, we'll call it a day. To Media Club, thank you, Principal, sir. Media Club, I really thank you because you have made all streaming it live. Thanks a lot. And tomorrow, students, once again, 4 to 5 will be live with one.
Sir has been muted also.
Fine. So thank you. Thank you, GEC Bhavnagar. Thank you all the faculty members of CS. And thank you, Principal sir, for giving such opportunity to me. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yes, yes. Thanks a lot, sir. And yes, we end here.